So in the previous videos, I've been discussing questions based on nature of haloalkanes. So this is one more question related to that. Yes, let us reason this. CCl bond length in chlorobenzene is shorter than CCl bond length in methyl chloride. Why? So let me just divide the bond into two and let me write chlorobenzene here. Chlorobenzene. Yes. Now one more compound given to us is methyl chloride. Now let us write the formula for both and see how should I reason the question. So in this particular case, chlorobenzene, this is a chlorobenzene, and in this particular case it is methyl chloride. So one carbon, chlorine attached, so one hydrogen, one more hydrogen, one more hydrogen, methyl chloride, done. Now a particular data is given to me, that is bond length. Bond length is 172 picometer given here, and 0.5 is given here. Bond length given is 178.5 picometer. Now they want us to reason this question. So first, when I start my answer, I'll first mention, or I have to concentrate at this particular point. I have to see what is the hybridization between CCl here. So the hybridization observed in this particular part is sp2 hybridization. And when I go to this carbon, the hybridization, all single bonds observed. So the hybridization observed here is sp3 hybridization, done. So half mark of this, you're going to just get half mark for this because you have clearly identified the type of hybridization. So once I write this, I have to write the S character, S percentage, and P character percentage in both. As we know, in sp2 hybridization, the percentage is, S character is 33%, and here it is 67% of this. When I come to your sp3 hybridization, your S character would be 25% and your P character would be 75% as it is. Yes. Now when I observe both, what are you observing? Here your S character is more, here the S character is less. So here this is where, this is the point where I have to stress clearly, more of S character, more of S character holding capacity towards nucleus, holding capacity would be greater. That's the most important point here. Let us write, because I'm comparing these two, less of S character. What is happening? If the less S character is higher, it's almost closer to the nucleus, and your binding capacity or holding capacity towards the nucleus is very great, higher. So here less of S character, I'm comparing this and this, less of S character, so holding capacity is less. So what's happening when it is holding tightly towards the nucleus? Automatically your bond length decreases. That is what they want us to write. So what am I going to write? When the S character is more, holding capacity is more. When the holding capacity is more, the particular compound or the particular, this one is closely tight or tightly packed towards the nucleus. So automatically, hence bond length is less, or bond length is low. That is what they have given me. See here, it is 172 picometer. Here, what will I write? Hence, bond length is more. This. So, just be careful. Whenever they have given you this, try to write in terms of hybridization. Try to write the S character. Try to write the P character in both of them. Then immediately say, if S character is more, holding capacity will be more. If the holding capacity is more, it is closer to the nucleus. If it is closer to the nucleus, automatically the bond length decreases. Thus, the question, whatever is given to us, is reasoned clearly. Thank you for watching.